coming up on From Glory to Glory.
In this life, that if you can access them, all of your financial challenges will be solved by just you doing exactly. And he says, not just to do the will of the one who sent me, he says, and to finish it.
As I look in the mirror, back home on the lawn, I am changed to his likeness. From glory to glory, from power to power, from strength to strength, I will never be the same.
Matthew chapter number 26. Today, as we are continuing on the theme of my financial breakthrough, today we just want to focus on the subject positioned for a financial breakthrough. Positioned for a financial breakthrough. Positioned for a financial breakthrough. Amen. Chelo makhulwane ubekezele nje uzomuzwa umfundisi noma akukhuluma ngesingisi uzomuzwa unga panic. Uzomuzo. Amen. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter number 26. I'm going to read from verse 36. And I really don't want to be long. Because I feel that I also need to pray for some people. Amen. Then Jesus came. Let me read properly. Then Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane and said to the disciples, "Sit here while I go and pray over there." And as I read through this story, right, notice how many times Jesus prays. And he is praying at a place called Gethsemane, okay? Which was really at the foot of the Mount of Olives. And that word Gethsemane can also be translated as the oil press. The oil press. The oil press. Because, and I want to just say this once and for all, just before I continue to read, that each and every one of us, when you are on your journey to greatness, to your financial breakthrough, or whatever the case may be, you are going to have this Gethsemane experience, which is not going to be nice. You are going to hear how Jesus was praying. Where if you want the anointing, whether it is for ministry, for healing, for financial breakthrough, or whatever, that God has got to squeeze it out of you. Amen. And sometimes it's not a nice experience. Hallelujah. Now, then in verse 37, it says, "And he took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, and he began to be sorrowful and deeply distressed." Which is the Lord. So it's not foreign when you are going through a rough patch. And you are sorrowful in your heart. But make sure that when you go through that time, you are going to remain prayerful. Because our biggest challenge as Christians is that when you experience tough times, then you cut off the very thing that is supposed to sustain you during that time. So Jesus was greatly distressed and he was sorrowful, but he was praying. In verse 38, it says, and take note how, he was with the crowd, sometimes walking also with the 12, but this time, he only took Peter and the sons of Zebedee. Because sometimes when you go through a rough time, you don't want to find yourself crowded. You only need key people in your life. And it might help you not to even depend on the few that are closer to you, because even they themselves can't carry you during that time. It is when God wants you and wants to deal with you and your story, nothing else and no one else. It has got nothing to do with people. You see, the reason why you've got to somehow only give access to a few people, it is simply for the reason of learning not to feel the rejection. Because it's almost natural for abantu ukuthi mawudlula esikhathini esinzima to forget about you. And don't take it to heart. Don't be too offended by that experience. Because vele sometimes God wants them away. So in verse 38, then it says, then he said to them, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even to death. This is now Jesus sensing that he's about to die. Then he says to them, stay here and watch with me. He was begging them. Have you ever been in a situation where you are phoning your friends? You are asking them to pray for you. And they promise that they are going to pray for you. But as soon as they hang up the phone, they send an SMS to someone else, saying, simkhulekise. And it becomes a chain of gossip that lacks prayer. And the conversation when it begins is like, asimkhulekise. And abakhulekise. How many conversations have you been involved in talking to your friend about a situation that someone else is facing and you were saying to them, ngicela simkhulekise? How many times have you prayed? Ngicela mombono amen ungitshele ukuthi kuphi. How many times have you actually, when you said to a person who was going through a rough time, you said to them, I'll pray with you, and you actually prayed? Sometimes these things do happen. So listen to what Jesus says. In verse 39, then it says, he went a little further and fell on his face and prayed, saying, oh, my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. I tell you, someone is going to be liberated today. If it is possible, this is Jesus almost begging God that, Lord, I don't have to go through this. It's Jesus saying, and he was saying to the disciples, even up to the point of death, I'm sorrowful up to the point. He says, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will. So even though Jesus is asking this, he knows that God is not going to budge. So before he finishes to pray, he changes the equation. He says, nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will. Verse 40. Then he came to the disciples and found them asleep. This is what I'm talking about. You are asking people, pray with me. And you come back and you find them sleeping. And he said to Peter, what? Could you not watch with me just 1 hour? Could you not just stand with me just for an hour? Couldn't you just visit me and just come and check me out just for an hour? So that at least I can feel ukuthi kukhona abantu abanami in this thing. Then in verse 41, it says, watch and pray, lest you enter into temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. This is where you sense in your spirit that this is the right thing to do. But your body says, I can't go through this. Your flesh says, I can't go through this. But your spirit is willing. In your spirit, you know this is what is supposed to happen. But your body says no. Again, a second time, he went away and prayed. So even when he was feeling weak, he was praying, saying, oh, my Father, if this cup cannot pass away from me unless I drink it. Your will be done. So the second time around, the language changes. He realizes, you know what? This has got to happen. Then he says, so be it. Let your will be done. If this cup is not going to pass away unless I drink it, your will be done. Angife kube kanye. Angife kube kanye. Angife kube kanye. You see, in the Bible, in the Old Testament, there is the Lord's goat and there is a scapegoat. The Lord's goat was killed at Tabernakelin, khona laphakat, there and there. But the other one, lebe babeki zandla phezukwayo, confess sins, bebayiyeka yofelis kangen. So for the first few days, probably it was going to try to survive. Running around, running from all sorts of danger, but at the end of the day, it's going to die. So sometimes you'd rather just be the Lord's goat and die now. Because in one or the other, Sheikh and Freck. In one or the other. Jenu makelwane lemineza na kuwe. Verse 43. And he came and found them asleep again. Yeah. Verse 44, so he left them, went away again, and prayed the third time, saying the same words. If this cup is not going to pass unless I drink it, let your will be done. Verse 45, then he came to his disciples and said to them, are you still sleeping and resting? Behold, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is being betrayed into the hands of sinners. You see, after he prayed these prayers three times, then he went back for the last time. You see, because there are certain offers that you must not make God, because he will take you up on the offer. See, when he came the last time, he said, Aish, so it's cut. The hour has come. See, like when you sing those songs, that you know, they carry an element of prayer in them. Inda do emnandi geya kongosi giso deze guyo. That's the part I like. Ya oi yenzani ngoba leso skathi uNkulunkulu lalele ezulwini uthi arakse nakulange kufuna khona uthi ngenze njani nginqobe intando yakho. Hey. See, those songs that when you sing, give me you. Anything else can wait. And God says, aha. Aha. I'd rather have Jesus than silver or gold. No mangi koka, manigi nigi. Yeah. That's when God says, aha, let me just take you through this season and see if you meant what you asked. So Jesus was sincere praying. God, if this cup is not going to pass without me drinking it, let your will be done. You see, it's a very deep spiritual prayer, and you think, you meant it. It's like, get on your feet. Let's go and kill you. Let's just go and kill you. Let's just go and kill you. And even when he wakes up the disciples, he says to them, look, the hour has come.
Bojang Christian Center presents new teaching titles that will change your life.
Access in, to the Father, and we gain access into the kingdom of God. Are we together? We gain access into the kingdom of God. Now, the kingdom of God, as described by Jesus, has pastures. Alone at home, ask him to fill you with the Holy Spirit and begin to speak in tongues. Amen. That's how I received it. That's how it happened. I didn't know all of these dynamics. No one taught me. I just heard Christians praying in tongues. And I went, I was alone, I asked God. We're eating dinner with the enemy. You're too nice. You're too nice. You're too nice. You are brushing the enemy. The enemy's back. You're too nice. You're too nice. You're too soft. You're too soft. You're too soft. You are not going to make it in this kingdom. Hey, the kingdom of God suffereth violence. The violent take it by force. You are too nice. You are too nice. Engage. Engage. Rise up, pray, bind, rebuke. Do whatever. Crawl on the floor. Lie on the floor. Call upon the name. Do something. From the blood.
We are in a battle. We are in a battle. We are agents of the kingdom of God. We are the soldiers. We are fighting to see this vision being fulfilled. But you are withdrawing the sword. You are withdrawing your skin.
These titles are available as DVD, MP3, and MP4 formats. Get yours now.
God's purpose. Ukuthi uzalwe abazali abanjani? Ukuthi uzalelwe phi in terms of the place or the surroundings? Ukuthi ufunde phi isikole? All of those elements are there to build this person that God needs. And that's why I always tell you, bazalwane bam, that you must never blame your parents for your failures in life. Never. Because even they themselves, there was never a time where they went to God and said, "Thina sicela uJonathan ozoba mute, ozoba namadevu, ozoshada noMonica." They never asked for it. They were just believing God for a child. But what kind of a child? God decided. For me to get a person with the caliber of a prophet or of a pastor or of a businessman or whatever the case may be, I require the combination of such DNAs. I require a couple ezohlala ePretoria so that as they grow, they can only do their part up to a certain point. But then God must take over and cause you to fulfill his will. So, each and every one of us, God has a will for our lives. God has a plan. I always tell you that one of the names of God means the one who is much more closer to us than we are to ourselves. So before you worry about your own life, God has got a full plan for it already. That's why David says that God is mindful of us. God is mindful of us. We were fearfully and wonderfully made. So that will that God has for our lives will bring stability in our lives. It will send us the kind of life that God has planned and purposed for us. And it is going to position us. If you are going to fulfill the will of God for your life, you are going to be in a proper position for you to be blessed even financially in your life. Amen. Jesus once said to his disciples, they went, bought food. He was ministering to the Samaritan woman. Went and bought food. They came back. They say to Jesus, "Here's some food to eat." And Jesus responds to them by saying, "My food is to do the will of him who sent me and to finish his work." He said, that is my food. Hey. Amen. You see, there are things in this life that has got your provision in them. Kukhona izinto in this life that if you can access them, all of your financial challenges will be solved by just you doing exactly. And he says, not just to do the will of the one who sent me, he says, and to finish it. Bill Gates, who's a computing. Steve Jobs, Google Apple Mac, and all the Apple products. Mining. Hallelujah. Babyface music. Hallelujah. Ugudla Guga Mfundi Vundla television production. So as we are seated here, each and every one of us, wandering around looking for financial solutions, you want to be blessed, you want to have money and whatever the case may be, let me tell you this. If you can locate the will of God for your life, that's where your food is. That's why you break. That's why Jesus said to them, by the time they came back with food, he said, does nothing to me. I have food that you are not aware of. He says, doing the will of the one who sent me and to finish it. If you can be obsessed with discovering the will of God for your life, let me tell you something, you will go far in life. You will be fed until you go to your grave. You will be provided for. All of our needs that we have, all of our needs that we have, they can be provided for if we can locate in Tando kaNkulunkulu for our lives. That's why then Jesus was in this, you know, sorrow, fighting, you know, to do the will of God in his life. Are we together, Bazalwane? So if you are not sure what the will of God is in your life, you better start praying about it. You better start inquiring from God, seeking the face of God to say, Lord, why am I here? Why do I find myself in Delmas? Why do I find myself in Konze PCC? Why do I find myself, you know, living in this province? Why at this time? Why, when you thought about me, what did you have in mind? Because that's where the will of God, that's where your food is. Because many of us, we live our lives just doing whatever epam gwetu. Simply because nami ngizithole ngenza lokhu. Are we together? Sometimes we become so desperate as abantu bakaNkulunkulu in such a way that we will just do anything that is in front of us. Anything. That's why I can't understand umuntu when you know yonke into entsha eqhamukayo, you want to be part of it. You want to do it. You just want to be involved in things just for the sake of being involved. You stumble into things. You find yourself becoming a policeman, not intentionally, but somehow you just found yourself a policeman. You just found yourself as a nurse. You just found yourself as a teacher. You don't know how did you get into it. How did you even decide? Let me tell you a story. I completed my matric in 1995, right? There's nothing strange about that. I'm still very young. Completed my matric in 1995. Was it 95 or 94? 95, yes. Completed in 1995. So, you know, when you pass, and then all of a sudden they say, you see your name on the newspaper. Then it means you've passed with an exemption. I don't know what do they call it now. Yeah. Bachelor, yeah. So all of a sudden, after seeing my name, I'm like thinking, "Ish, you funda in school?" I want to go to school, but I don't know what am I going to do there. So I go, obviously, I go and try and register. Stand on that long queue. I'm still scratching my head, trying to think, what am I going to do? So I go, the first course I mention, you know, they say, no, we don't have that here. And then they give me a booklet. And then I just go through it. And then I see a fancy name there.
To order today's message and other sermons preached at BCC, you can call us, email us, or visit our online store. These messages are available as digital downloads and also as DVDs and CDs. Staying in touch has never been easier. Introducing BCC's brand new app. With the latest events, notifications, monthly declarations, audio and video sermons. Now you can stay in touch with BCC via your phone or tablet anytime and anywhere.
In the dark world of confusion and pain, stand up and stand out. Be seen, be fair. Do not blend in, but blend out. Join us for our second annual Aflame Deep Conference, Salt and Light, on the 28th and 29th July 2016, 6 p.m. every evening with Pastor Jacob Nsipa, Pastor Pearson Victoria, and our very own Solomon Spencer. For more information, visit us on www.bcc.org. Hashtag Salt and Light. Be seen, be felt.